Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to Legend of Mana. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenral. And today we're picking up where we left off last time when we were doing the Two Torches main quest. Apparently the one place I didn't check was the dungeon, and that's where we're supposed to go. I wanted to avoid going through this place because it's a freaking maze, but we got Escad over here and Daena over here. Anyways, we can't find them. Monsters aren't supposed to be able to come in and out of the sanctuary. They could be in the meditation room. Arranged it to be open in case of emergency. Well, I'm gonna go look for them. And off she goes. Alright, what do you gotta say, you prick?
Lost them. This place is too vast to search. We're gonna be hiding, waiting until we're gone.
So I've gotten away somehow.
I'm gonna look for a little more.
Well, I'm more concerned where Daena went to, because I lurk here a lot more than Escad, because Escad is a jerk. A real jerk that I don't really care too much to hang around with all that much. So I'm gonna take a look and see if I can find Daena around here somewhere. And I forgot I had fist weapons equipped, and I'm still learning abilities. So, I think that was my third one. No, it's my fourth one. So, Blade Knuckles, Lightning Kick, and Whirlwind Kick. Since those are our first three, let's use those. Also, let's change over to something else. I'm gonna keep Moonsault on pretty much permanently at this point, so yeah, let's do bash for now. I mean, we got fist weapons, so maybe we can bash some enemies as well as bash them up with our fists, of course. So I have no idea where I'm going in here, and so we're gonna have to look around until we find either Daena or Escad. I think I've settled on calling her Daena at this point, even though it probably would be better if they spelt it with an I rather than an E and had the A in the other spot. But either way, I think that's how it's supposed to be pronounced. Alrighty, we got Toss. A generic ability, I'm assuming, that we haven't learned yet. So we're gonna, I'm not gonna equip that just yet. We just equipped Bash, so we're gonna keep that on for the time being. But yeah, I do know I've still got a few more generic moves that I haven't learned yet. Before I started the last episode, I actually looked in my encyclopedias in my house and saw I was still missing a few basic abilities, which is why I want to still keep shuffling around as we go. Also, he's a fire in his laser. Yeah, I'm kind of glad I actually got him that logic block last time, considering the fact that as I was, you know, poking around for a quest, as I said before, he kind of stood around and did nothing. Also, I came here when I was looking around for a quest, and there's apparently supposed to be a quest here, but the whole barrel in their soul thing is an important thing to remember for later, because I remember you need to have a barrel in your soul to complete some quest somewhere along the line, but there's a quest that allows you to get one, which apparently we don't have just yet. So I don't know where exactly that's going to be at, but eventually we'll find that quest, and then we'll be able to do this quest. So, yeah. But anyways, where the heck are we now? Yeah, we're just going to kind of wander around this place. Like I said before, it's quite a bit of a maze, so I have no idea where either of these two are hanging out at, so hopefully we'll just wander around long enough until we bump into one or the other. And once again, as I was saying with, you know, was it making a logic block for my golem? I really haven't pointed this out just yet, but there are times when he will, you know, do his little error thing, and I'll try to point it out next time he has an error or has a malfunction. But because I didn't have that one logic block that had that laser attack, he would do that quite a bit. He would just air out a lot as he was hanging around kind of where we started each battle. And whenever he does it... Oh, we got two more moves. Rolling Slam and Moonsault Stomp. Well, I have a feeling those are actual fist weapon attacks. So, we will look at them eventually once we start using the higher level moves. But yeah, going back to the golem, whenever he airs out, you'll see a little puff of smoke come out of his head. And it kind of looks like a little angry sign, or it looks like he's getting a bit angry or something like that. And that's your cue that he's airing out. And if he's not doing many attacks and he's doing that a lot, it's a good sign. Yeah, like he just did right there. It's a good sign that he doesn't know what he's got to do here, because, you know, he doesn't have enough logic blocks, he doesn't have enough programs to tell him, what do I got to do in a situation like this? So, I'm thinking sooner or later we're probably going to make more logic blocks. We're probably going to do some shopping too, eventually, and just make a bunch of stuff to make logic blocks out of. And I think that'll be a good idea for, you know, eventually as we go forward. I don't know why he's shooting his laser that way, because the enemies are down here. Alright, got a couple skeletons down. XP for me, and kind of piddly XP around here, because we placed this place way early in the game. Okay, this looks like we need to go this way. Monsters are even appearing in the homeland of Gato. How sorrowful it is to see the flow of mana energy weakening so. Alright, so this might be our sanctuary that we need to find. So, I see a treasure chest here. Let's go grab it. Holy water. I'm stealing your church's holy water. And I'm invading your sanctuary and all that. So, oh, these guys. We haven't seen these guys too terribly often. There might be some kind of ghost type enemy, or I don't know. I think we saw some of those in the junkyard, but... or maybe it was the jungle, I don't know. But we've seen them a couple times, but not very frequently. And what's this over here? More little shadow dudes! And it's kind of interesting, because I remember some of my save files have them as the icon. and you won't see that unless, you know, I opened up the CD door whenever I start up the game and stuff. But yeah, a lot of these save icons for this game are, some of them are enemies. Actually, I think they're all enemies, I'm not entirely sure, but I'm guessing, depending on which slot you save on, certain enemies will be the icon for your game. And we got a deep cave here. Did we go all the way through and not find where we're supposed to go? Is this like a back door, or... Maybe it's a back door. Are we supposed to find something in the air between those two nuns? Maybe so. Yeah, I think we fought these guys before, but I'm gonna go a screen or two further before I backtrack. And also, these triad enemies, if I remember right, they appear in a later dungeon, probably one of the last artifacts that we'll place. And when you place them, that particular artifact can go much further in the game. I think I remember having to farm those triad guys for a particularly rare type of wood. I forget what I needed the wood for. Like I said, it's been forever, but I remember that those particular enemies, when they're at a high level, drop a pretty rare type of wood. And I think it's like the best type of wood in the game. So maybe if you want to make a really killer staff or an instrument, I think you need that kind of wood. Yeah, I'm not seeing where I have to go today. If I can jump over that way. So, is there like a backward... No, I don't see a pathway back there. So there's probably a side path around here somewhere that I just didn't see. Alright. EXP first, and then a little coinage. Alright, so is there like... a place to drop off? In the passageway. Is that a back door there? No. So where do I have to go? It might be on this screen. I don't know. Anything on that side screen? Maybe. Alright. Let's move around. I still hate this plane of, you know, you gotta be directly to the side of them or else your attacks on this kind of deal. Is this where I need to go? I don't think I went this way. This might be it. Ah, here we go. You didn't even realize this was a trap! Abbess Matilda, you must bring her to safety! Wait, are you... one of those fairies that we saw in the jungle? I actually noticed this in editing, but they said this old lady here is actually 26 years old. And Escad, when he came back to see her again, said, "Wow, you've aged quite a bit in the 10 years I was gone," when he was in the underworld. So I'm guessing she lost a lot of her mana or something. And she aged rapidly. That's why she's only 26. Looks like a grandma. But yeah, the fairies apparently wanted her for their queen. And they were complaining about how humans die so young. I don't know. Either way, we're not magical beings, fairies. We can't live for thousands of years. Ways this way, Abbess. That's right. Keep her out of this battle, but I'll get her back. Take her for now. The show is about to begin. So what, boss fight? Take Matilda to Lord Ingwen after this battle. Well, shall we start the party? Yep, boss fight.
Come on.
All right, and admittedly not the best boss fight to use gloves on. I should have had a longer range weapon for that, but then again, I didn't know it was coming. Either way, Escad, please listen to me. No, Matilda. You should rest, so I'll say it. No, I will. Escad, I do not want to give up my freedom to become a priestess. Erwin only wanted to free me from life bound by rules. Wake up, Matilda. Stop letting the demon do this to you. Did you ever consider how Erwin will use the power he took from you? That's enough, Escad. And you, Matilda, you need a rest. You never took me seriously, even when we were children. I'm not going to let the demon gain any more power. I don't need to have any shyness covers me. Don't say such a thing. Alright, we got ourselves some iron. And the end of a quest. Another main quest. But that Escad's still thick. I am not on his side. He just keeps doing whatever he thinks is right and it's his way. Anyway, I hate guys like that sometimes. Anyway, time to go back to Daena and record our Daena. Because we're going to get ourselves another journal entry. Red carpet. Well, yeah, that boss that we fought did use the red carpet as a weapon. He kind of did the old lift the carpet up and try to sweep you off your feet move. But either way, let's see what he's got to say about this quest. Two torches, I believe it's called. Right, number 7. So we've almost got everything filled up here. Alright. Cat-eared woman and a long-haired man had a fight. And the grandma was kidnapped. And the two found the grandma. I think this kind of story is getting old. Is that supposed to be like a reference to Mario or something? Or just princess kidnappings in general or something? Either way, Matilda isn't exactly a princess. Eh? Well, whatever. Want to save my game here. And I think what we need to do to continue that main quest line is go back to Gato Grottoes and see where that takes us. I think we need to go back to Matilda's room. So, yeah, I'm just going to pick Lisa right back up, and I will meet you back in Gato Grottoes, back in Matilda's room. Alright, we're back, and apparently, our Hypocrite is calling you. He's going. Alright, so apparently, because we did such a good job last time, she probably needs our help to probably sort out this whole matter between Erwin, Escad, and Daena, as well as herself. I apologize to have called upon you. Just a favor I need to ask you. It's about Daena. She left here saying she needed to talk to Erwin. He'll come back soon. Could you go please find her? Well, not. Sure thing. Thank you so much. I wish you luck. Alright, in search of fairies. Another main quest. And, yes, I did look this up, and apparently we're supposed to go back to the jungle, which is apparently why all that time ago, when we were supposed to do Gaius's Wisdom, I was still in the clear, because apparently Daena comes back here after some time. And if I were to wager a guess, the last quest we did that involved Daena and Escad, plus perhaps the one that we did before that one in the jungle where we met Escad to begin with, and he slaughtered a bunch of fairies, I have a feeling that's kind of where the cutoff point is probably at for doing Gaius's Wisdom and getting that Forbidden Ring that I have. Well, I don't have that equipped right now. I could have it equipped just so Lisa isn't so frail, because she did fall in that last boss fight. So I really don't want her to be a liability, I mean, she is a spellcaster, so she shouldn't be really getting into the thick of things too much. But then again, when you have a boss is doing wide range attacks like that guy did a few times, yeah, it's probably not a good idea to make it so she's under level of time. Since I'm going to bringing her along a lot, and she has more value of a spellcaster than probably a melee friend would be. Anyways, now we'll go to the Forested Ruins, back to where the Fair Territory is, but I'm gonna go back over here really quick. And you know what, yeah, let's... What's her level, by the way? She's only level 21 and I'm 30? Yeah, I think I'm gonna level up Lisa a bit for the time being, since she kinda is my main secondary party member. Unless, of course, Daena decides to join us here, since we're looking for her after all. Let's talk to Rizzialte. Have you gotten used to the Force Pass? No! When you begin to enjoy being lost, you're relieved of English. What do you wish to ask me? let's ask about Daena and see if she's been around here. Maybe I'll look for Irwin, but left a little while ago. Told her to go to Lake Kilma, where more fairies live. Toad the tortoise should be able to help her. Okay, so we need to go to Lake Kilma. Still, I don't know. I do not know if Toad is a he or she. I guess even the spirits don't know everything. So, I guess we're going to have to try and find our way out of here. And I'm going to be terribly lost once again. Is there someone? I thought I saw someone there, but it might have been just my golem friend. I don't know. Either way. We did go to this screen before, I think, and fight a boss. Or maybe it's the next screen. I did want to explore this way a little bit more, since it's probably the only area here in the forest that I have not been into. And also, I'm confused. So left is right and right is left. That's kind of why I'm attacking the right edge of the screen when they're over in the center. Alright, so what's down here? Also, apparently my golem still gets EXP even though he doesn't have a level. How's that work? Yes, I do remember fighting these guys. I remember commenting on how these guys are like 90% mouth. Entire body is their mouth. Minus a little dongle on their head and their arms. And those are weird looking enemies. Either way. Got some small seeds. There may there some kind of plant enemy. I believe that enemy there is a type of dragon. It might be, or it might be just kind of some type of dinosaur. I don't know. And that's the other move that my golem has. He used it in the boss fight, I think, once or twice. And I think he even got a hit with it once, but it's kind of a lackluster fight or ability. Oh, and a monster egg. Is that a demon egg? Yeah, it's a demon egg. It's got little horns and wings and forked tail. I ain't going for demons though, so at least not yet. There's a demi-human that I want to get later on that probably would be considered a demon. But, I hope I don't have too limited stable space. I'm pretty sure we're only supposed to have 5 pets at most. And I think that's kind of weird, though, that they restrict you so much on how many pets you can have. Considering this, even though this is a PS1 game, I think it takes up, like, 2 memory card blocks. So, I don't know, I don't know, actually. I'm thinking about, you know, maybe stopping in the middle of a quest again today, because we're already getting a ways up there in time. So we might stop and, like, kill him about halfway through and finish up searching for Daena and in search of fairies when we get there. For now, though, I'm going to try to find my way out of here. Pretty much just aimless wandering until I figure out where the exit is. I find the screen with the flowerling on it, then I know I'm at the entrance. But till then, I gotta just wander around until I find the exit. Alright, we're finally out of that goddamn forest, and we're back in Lake Kilma. Also, I want to go this way really quickly, since we kind of came here to kill that golem that Professor Bomb created, and then it went vagrant. And we didn't really explore this section of the forest after that. It's probably just going to be a dead end, but well, at least we found a treasure chest. Mothwing. Eh, more lackluster loot, more crafting crap, as usual, but you know, just gotta gather it all as we go. Anyways, so we gotta figure out where Toad is, and still a bunch of enemies around here. When I was trying to get out of the forest, I did learn a move or two. And you know what? I think we've had the gloves on for a little while now, so you know what? It's time to take the gloves off. And let's get ourselves something else instead. And let's take a look at our new moves. I think the last one we saw was Giant Swing and Moonstomp, or Moonsault Stomp. Now we have Tiger Driver 91, whatever 91 is supposed to stand for. Northern Lights and Mental Barrier. I don't know if we actually saw those get learned on screen or not, but did learn something not too long ago. What was it? Toss. New ability. And let's equip something other than gloves. What have we not used? We have not used staves. That's not a very strong attack power stave, but let's just learn a few basic abilities and try to get we'll try to get a few before we get to wherever Daena is, and hopefully we'll learn a few moves along the way. And yeah, I'm not doing a whole lot of damage to these guys, am I? At least he's taking down those tadpoles. I was not expecting the laser to just come by while I was grabbing loot. Either way, candy. I want candy. Alright, so I don't know how many screens farther we're actually going to have to go. There's no penguins really telling us where to go in here. I do remember seeing, at some point in time, we saw a bunch of fairies on the left side of the screen as soon as we entered, and then they all disappeared. Wow, Lisa. Got them all in a single attack. Yeah, one of the good reasons to have a spellcaster like Lisa is, even though that particular range of that spell is like completely random, as you can see, she missed twice, she can still get a good few good hits off just kind of hanging out on the side of the screen and kind of safely away from, you know, where all the action is happening, where is where I am going to be at. Anywho, I probably should try and use that toss ability at some point in time or another, but let's see what it does, actually. Oh, it kind of launches them straight upwards. I guess that's good for a setup if you're going to use your abilities of some sort. Or maybe your spell. It might be better for spells since it's kind of easier to time spells. Yeah, as I was saying like last time, I think, staves acts a lot like spears in battle. In fact, I think it's like the same animation. So it's kind of like, they're comparable, like how one-handed or two-handed swords and hammers and two-handed axes pretty much all act the same in battle, no matter, you know, even though they're different weapon types, they are fairly similar and how you use them in battle. And I got burps coming up. Either way. Let's kill this guy. Get through here. Man, we learned bubbles and blades. So, of course, staff special abilities are going to be more like spells than, you know, beat the crap out of someone with your wooden stick. Alright, and kill you. And grab my loot. More loot. And you're not close enough, Lisa. You missed. Now we get Gust. So, those abilities, now we have them. Two gusts. Hold on a sec. Bubbles. And blaze. Alright, so we're good for ST moves for time being, in case we get a boss. It's kinda out of nowhere. And you know what? Here's a save point. And you know what? I'm gonna stop here again in the middle of the quest, rather than at the end. And we're gonna continue this later in the next episode. So I am SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Fenral. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.